Good evening, everybody. My name is Kiran. I'm working as an assistant professor in the department of EEE UNITS. I welcome you all to my second lecture on two-port network. In my previous lecture, I have discussed the basic concepts of two-port network, that is the standard equations and applications of Z, Y, H and ABCD parameters. I also derived the condition of reciprocity as well as symmetry for Z, Y, H and ABCD parameters. In today's lecture, we are going to see some tutorials on Z, Y, H and ABCD parameters. So in the first tutorial, he has asked us to find the Z parameters for the given network. So according to the standard equations, we know that V1 is equal to Z11I1 plus Z12I2. V2 is equal to Z21I1 plus Z22I2. Here we will consider two cases. In first case, we will consider I2 to be 0. In second case, I will consider I1 to be 0. The first case, open circuiting the output port, that is I2 is equal to 0. When I2 becomes 0, that is open circuiting the port 2, this impedance Z2 can be eliminated from the circuit and I'll be left with only Z1 and Z3. Even though current is 0, the voltage V2 at the output port will still exist, and in this case it appears across the impedance Z3. So on application of KVL to this loop, I'll get V1 is equal to 26 plus J36 into I1, which will give me Z11 V1 by I1 to be 26 plus J36 ohms. But V2 is the voltage across J36 ohms. So V2 I can write as J36 into I1, which will give me the value of Z21 V2 by I1 to be J36 ohms. In second case, I'll consider open circuiting the port 1. So when I open circuit the port 1, the impedance Z1 can be eliminated from the circuit and I'll be left only with Z2 and Z3. Even though the current I1 is 0, the voltage V1 will appear across the impedance Z3. On application of KVL to this circuit, I'll get V2 to be J36 minus J56 into I2, which gives me the value of Z2 to V2 by I2 to be minus J20 ohms. Since V1 is the voltage across Z3, V1 I can write as J36 into I2, which will give me the value of Z1 to V1 by I2 to be J36 ohms. So moving forward to second tutorial, find Z parameters for the given circuit. We know the standard equations of Z parameters. In first case, let me consider open circuiting the output port. When I open circuit the output port, the 3 ohm resistor can be eliminated from the circuit. So after eliminating, I will be left with the following circuit as shown in circuit A. So here, the current through 2 ohm resistor is unknown, so I have assumed the current to be I1 dash. Next, this 5 ohm resistor as well as 2 ohm resistor are in series, which is 7 ohms, and that 7 ohms is in parallel with 4 ohm resistor. So upon this parallel combination, I can further reduce my circuit A into circuit B as shown, which will give me the parallel combination of 7 ohms and 4 ohms to be 2.54 ohms. So now, using this condition I2 is equal to 0, try to find the Z parameters Z11 as well as Z21. So from circuit B, when I apply KVL, I'll get V1 is equal to 3.54 I1, which will give me the value of Z11, which is V1 by I1 to be 3.54 ohms. From circuit A, Since voltage V2 is a voltage across 5 ohms, I can write V2 as 5 into I1 dash. I have indicated that as equation 1. So here I have 2 ohms as well as 5 ohms in series. This is considered as one branch, and I have another 4 ohm resistor. These two branches are in parallel, and these two parallel branches have a total current of I1. So I1 dash is the current in one of the parallel branches. So in such situation, I can apply current division rule in order to find the relation between I1 and I1 dash. So in this case, from circuit A, according to current division rule, states that current in one of the parallel branches is equal to the total current into opposite resistance divided by sum of all resistances. So here I1 dash is the current in one of the parallel branches. I1 is the total current to the parallel branch of 4 ohms and 7 ohms. 4 ohms is nothing but the opposite resistance. That is, since here I1 dash is the current flowing in this branch, the opposite resistance will be nothing but 4 ohms divided by the total resistance in the parallel combination, that is 4 plus 2 plus 5. Remember that here 1 ohm resistor should not be included in the formula. The total resistance includes only those resistances which are in the two parallel branches. So according to current division rule, I will get the relation between I1 dash and I1. Substituting equation 2 in equation 1, I will get the value of Z21, which is V2 by I1, to be 1.81 ohms. The second case, open circuiting the port 1, which will eliminate 1 ohm resistor from the circuit. And I'll be left with the following circuit, which is indicated as circuit A. Here V1 voltage will appear across 4 ohm resistor, and here the current through 2 ohm resistor is assumed to be I2 dash. So here 4 ohms and 2 ohms are in series, which will give me 6 ohms, and this 6 ohms is in parallel with 5 ohms. So further, I can reduce the given circuit as shown, and this parallel combination of 6 ohms and 5 ohms will give me 2.7 ohms. Here, in this case, using these two circuits and the condition I1 is equal to 0, we try to find the parameters Z12 as well as Z2. So from circuit B, on applying KVL, will give me V2 to be 5.7 into I2, which will give me the value of Z22, which is V2 by I2, to be 5.7 ohms. From the circuit A, as we have seen in last case also, here since 4 and 2 ohms are in series, when I consider that as one branch, and 5 ohms as another branch, these two branches are in parallel, and the current, total current to this parallel branches is I2. And since I have wound the relation between I2 and I2 dash, I have to apply current division rule in order to get this relation. From the given circuit, that is circuit A, V1 can be written as 4 into I2 dash. Applying current division rule, current in one of the parallel branches, that is I2 dash, is equal to total current, which is I2, into opposite resistance. In this case, it is 5 ohms divided by sum of all resistances in the parallel branches, that is 5 plus 4 plus 2 ohms. Substituting this second equation and first equation will give me the value of Z12, which is V1 by I2 to be 1.81 ohms. The third tutorial starts to find Z parameters. In this case also, in the first case, by open circuiting the output port and get the following circuit. Assume current in this 1 ohm resistor to be I1 dash and this 1 ohm resistor to be I2 dash. Further, as you can see, 1 ohm and 2 ohm resistor are in series and this 3 ohms is in parallel with 2 ohms. So this parallel combination will give me 1.2 ohms as indicated in circuit B. Further, if I simplify, these 1 ohm and 1.2 ohms are in series, which again is in parallel with this 2 ohm resistor, which will give me the modified circuit as shown, circuit C, and this parallel combination will give me the resistor value to be 1.04 ohms. So now, using these three circuits and the condition I2 is equal to 0, if I try to find the values of the parameters Z11 as well as Z21. So from circuit C, if I apply KVL, I will get V1 to be 2.04 into I, which will give me the value of Z11. V1 by I1 to be 2.04 ohms. So from circuit A, in order to get the relation between I2 dash and I1 dash, I have to apply current division rule. Here V2 is nothing but 2 into I2 dash as shown in circuit A. So according to current division rule, current in one of the parallel branches, that is I2 dash, is equal to total current, in this case is I1 dash, into opposite resistance is 2 ohms divided by all the resistance in parallel, that is 2 plus 1 plus 2, that is 5 ohms. So I have indicated as equation 2. So from circuit B, again applying current division rule will give me the relation between I1 dash and I1. So current in one of the parallel branches, that is I1 dash, is equal to total current I1 into opposite resistance, that is 2 ohms divided by 2 plus 1 plus 1.2, indicated as third equation. So here I'll substitute this. Let me go to previous slide. My aim is to find the relation between V2 and I1. Okay. So equation 2 will give me the relation between I2 dash and I1 dash, and equation 3 will give me the relation between I1 dash and I1. So using these second and third equations, I'll directly substitute this in first equation. The first equation is nothing but V2 is equal to 2 into I2 dash. From that, from second equation, I2 dash is nothing but I1 dash into 2 by 5. And from third equation, I1 dash is nothing but I1 into 2 divided by 2 plus 1 plus 1.2. Okay. So on simplification, will give me the value of Z21, which is V2 by I1, to be 0.38 ohms. Now, considering the second case, that is open circuiting input port I10, will eliminate this 1 ohm resistor from the circuit. And on simplification will give me the following circuit, which is indicated as circuit A. Again, this 2 ohms and 1 ohms are in series, which is in parallel with 2 ohm resistor, and this power combination can be further simplified as circuit B as shown. Here 1.2 ohms is the parallel combination of 3 ohms as well and 2 ohms. So further again here 1 ohms as well as 1.2 ohms are in series, which is in parallel with 2 ohm resistor. So this parallel combination will again further reduce my circuit as shown by circuit C, and this parallel combination will give me the value of even resistance to be 1.04 ohms. So I'm using these three circuits and the condition I10, find the values of parameters Z12 as well as Z22. From circuit C, if I apply KVL, V2 will be 1.04 I2, which will give me the value of Z22 to be V2 by I2 as 1.04 ohms. From circuit A, here the relation between I1 dash as well as I2 dash can be obtained by current division rule. Here V1 can be written as 2 into I1 dash. According to current division rule, the current in one of the parallel branches, that is I1 dash, is equal to total current I2 dash into opposite resistance, that is 2 ohms divided by sum of resistances 1 ohm, 2 ohms and 2 ohms. Okay. So here for this current division rule, I have considered only this part of circuit. So on considering only this part of circuit, I have applied current division rule. So similarly, when I consider circuit B, here also on applying current division rule, current in one of the parallel branches I2 dash is equal to total current I2 and the opposite resistance 2 ohms divided by 1.2 plus 2 is 1 ohms. So here I have indicated them as equations 2 and 3. Substituting these two equations in first equation. First equation is V1 is equal to 2I1 dash. Using the second equation, I1 dash is equal to I2 dash into 2 by 5. And further, using the third equation, I2 dash is equal to I2 into 2 divided by 2 plus 1 plus 1 into 2. I'll get the relation between V1 and I2, that is Z12 to be 0.38 ohms. So the next tutorial is asked us to find Y parameters. The standard equation of Y parameters, as you know, I1 is equal to Y11 V1 plus Y12 V2. I2 is equal to Y21 V1 plus Y22 V2. So in this case, in first case, I'll consider V2 to be 0, and in second case, I'll consider V1 to be 0. That is short circuiting either first port as well as or second port. The first case, short circuiting the output port. So as soon as I short circuit the output port, as you can see, this resistor 4 ohms is in parallel with the short circuit. So we know that if any resistor is in parallel with a short circuit, no current will flow through this resistor. So it can be eliminated from the circuit. So therefore in this case, I can rewrite my given circuit as shown, applying nodal analysis, assuming the voltages here to be V1 and V2. Obviously V2 is anyhow 0. So first applying nodal analysis at node 1, entering current at node 1 is I1. So these two are leaving currents. So the equation will be I1 is equal to V1 by 2 plus V1 minus V2 by 3. Here in place of V2, as you know, it is equal to 0 volts. This on simplification will give me the value of Y11, which is I1 by V1 to be 0.833 ohms. Applying analysis at second node, the entering current is I2, and these two if I assume to be leaving currents, so equation will be I2 is equal to 3I2 plus V2 minus V1 by 3, and here V2 as we know is 0 volts. This on simplification will give me directly the value of Y21, which is I2 by V1 to be 1 by 6 ohms. The second case, when I short circuit the input port, here 2 ohm resistor will come in parallel with the short circuit, hence I can eliminate, modifying the given circuit as shown. Applying node analysis at the second node, the entering current if I assume to be I1, so I1 will be V2 by 4 plus this current, and this current further I can split into these two currents. This current I can indicate as 3I2, and this current I can indicate as minus I2. Here I1, since this is short circuit, here I can indicate that the voltage at this node is nothing but 0 volts. So I1 I can write as 0 minus V2 by 3. So if I substitute this in the above expression, I'll get the equation minus V2 by 3 is equal to V2 by 4 plus 3I2 minus I2, which will give me the value of Y22, that is I2 by V2 to be minus 0.29 ohms. And now using this relation, I'll substitute in the given obtained equation at node 2 to get the another relation. So using this relation, I can write I2 as minus 0.29 into V2. So this I'll substitute in the expression that we have got at node 2, that is I1 is equal to V2 by 4 plus 3I2 minus I2. So on substitution, I'll get the value of Y12 to be minus 0.33 ohms, which is nothing but I1 by V. Moving forward to the fifth tutorial, he has asked us to find both Z parameters as well as Y parameters. Now applying KVL to the first port will give me the equation to be 8I1 plus 0.1V2 to be V1. And on applying node analysis or Kirchhoff's current law KCL to second node, will give me I2 is equal to 0.05V1 plus V2 by 12. So here also the voltage at this node is nothing but V2. So now this I can rewrite as V2 is equal to 12I2 minus 0.6V1. Assuming it as equation 2. Now, if I substitute the second equation and first equation, I'll get the expression as 8I1 plus 1.2I2 is equal to 1.06V1. So, this I can rewrite as V1 is equal to 7.54I1 plus 1.13I2. Now, if I compare this with the standard equation of Z parameters, give me directly value of Z11 to be 7.54 ohms and Z12 to be 1.13 ohms. So from equation 2, substituting equation 1 and equation 2, I'll get the equation as V2 is equal to 11.3 I2 minus 4.52 I1. If I compare this standard equation of Z parameters, that is the second equation, Z21, I'll get as minus 4.52 ohms, and Z22, which is 11.3 ohms. So this is an alternate way how we can find Z parameters without using the conditions, that is I2 0 and I1 0. So after finding the Z parameters, we know that admittance Y is nothing but the inverse of impedance Z. So substituting this in the following relation, this Z parameters I can write in the matrix form as shown, and the inverse of the Z matrix can be found out, which will give me the value of Y matrix. So substituting all these values will directly give me the values of Y parameters Y11, Y12, Y21 and Y22 as shown. So moving forward to the sixth tutorial, it asks us to find the transformed Z and Y parameters. Please keep in mind that whenever I have inductor and capacitor, everything should be transformed into Laplace domain. So hence the given inductor 1 Henry I can write as 1 into S, and 1 Farad I can write as 1 by S. So transforming the given circuit into Laplace domain will give me the circuit as shown. So we know the standard equations of Z parameters. In first case, if I open circuit, the output port, 1 by S capacitor can be eliminated, which will give me the following circuit. Here on applying KVL to this circuit, it will give me 1 by S into I1 plus S into I1 is equal to V1. It will give me the value of Z11 to be S square plus 1 by S. But V2 is nothing but S into I1. From this I can get the value of Z21, which is V2 by I1 to be S. In second case, when I open circuit the input port, this capacitor 1 by S can be eliminated. So when I eliminate this capacitor, give me the following circuit as shown, and on applying KVL to this circuit, give me V2 is equal to 1 by S plus S into I2, which will give me the value of Z22, which is V2 by I2 to be S square plus 1 by S. But V1 is the voltage across S, which is S into I2. And this will give me the value of Z12, that is V1 by I2 to be S. So after finding Z parameters, we know that Y is nothing but inverse of Z. Substituting the obtained relations of Z in the following expression will give me the values of Y parameters Y11 and Y22 to be S into S square plus 1 by 2 S square plus 1, and Y12 as well as Y21 to be minus S cube by 2 S square plus 1. The seventh tutorial, to find the transformed Z and Y parameters. Since here also we have inductor capacitor, so the resistor value will have no effect even in Laplace domain. The inductor will transform as S and capacitor will transform as 1 by S. So now finding the Z parameters, in first case open circuiting the output port will eliminate the capacitor from the circuit, will give me the modified circuit as shown. On applying KVL, V1 will be S plus 1 into I1, which will give me the value of Z11 which is V1 by I1 to be S plus 1. V2 is the voltage across 1 ohm resistance. Therefore, V2 is equal to 1 into I1, which will give me the value of Z21 to be V2 by I1 as 1 ohms. The second case, if I open circuit, the port 1 will eliminate the inductor S from the circuit, which modifies my circuit as shown. And on applying KVL, will give me V2 is equal to 1 by S plus 1 into I2, leading to a value Z22, which is V2 by I2 to be S plus 1 by S. Since V1 is the voltage across 1 ohm resistor, V1 is equal to 1 into I2, which will give me the value of Z12, which is V1 by I2 to be 1 ohm. So after finding Z parameters, we know the Y is equal to inverse of Z, and on substituting the relation and finding the inverse of the matrix will give me the value of Y parameters as shown. So next, the 8th tutorial has given this equations V1 is equal to 60I1 plus 20I2, V2 is equal to 20I1 plus 40I2, and asked us to find Z and Y parameters. So directly the given equations are in the standard form, and comparing them with the standard equations of Z directly give me Z11 to be 60 ohms, Z22 to be 40 ohms, Z12 and Z21 to be 20 ohms. And Y, since it is inverse of Z, finding the inverse of the matrix will give me the values of Y parameters, Y11 to be 0.02 mhos, Y22 to be 0.03 mhos, and Y12 as well as Y21 to be minus 0.01 mhos. So the next tutorial, given that I1 is equal to 0.5 V1 minus 0.2 V2, I2 is equal to minus 0.2 V1 plus V2, asks us to find both Y as well as Z parameters. As you can see, the given equations are already in the standard form of Y parameters. So directly when we compare them to the standard equation, will directly give me the values of Y11 to be 0.5 mhos, Y22 to be 1 mhos, Y12 and Y21 to be minus 0.2 mhos. So on inverse of Y parameters, will give me the value of Z parameters, Z11 to be 2.17 ohms, Z22 to be 1.08 ohms, and Z12 and Z21 to be 0.43 ohms. The 10th tutorial, I will leave this as an exercise for you. Try to find the values of Z as well as Y parameters for the given network. You can cross check and verify your answers as I am leaving the answers for this sum. So the next tutorial asks us to find H parameters for the given circuit. Here I have a dependent current source in parallel with the resistance. Using the source transformation, I will modify my circuit as shown. We know that V is equal to I into R, I value is 2 into I1, R is 2 ohms, so which will give me the value of voltage source to be 4I1. Since the arrowhead is downwards, I'll get the positive here and negative here. Now using this modified circuit, we'll find H parameters. The standard equations of H parameters are V1 is equal to H11 I1 plus H12 V2, and I2 is H21 I1 plus H22 V2. First, short circuiting the output port, that is V2 is equal to 0, we'll get the following circuit. And on applying mesh analysis, assuming currents to be I1 and I2, I'll get the equations first equation to be 2i1 plus 2 into i1 plus i2 minus 4i1 is equal to v1. As you can observe that both the currents are assumed in the same direction. Hence, instead of writing i1 minus i2, I have got here i1 plus i2. As you can see here, 4i1 minus 4i1 will get cancelled, and this will be left with 2i2 is equal to v1. On the second mesh equation, I have got 2i2 plus 2 into i1 plus i2 minus 4i1 is equal to 0. So on simplification, I will get 4i2 is equal to 2i1. So after obtaining these two equations, here from the second equation, directly I will get the value of h21, which is i2 by i1, to be 1 by 2. There are no units since it's the ratio of similar quantities. And now I will substitute this in the first equation, which will give me the value of h11, which is v1 by i1, to be 1. So then the second case, that is, now I will open circuit the input port. When I open circuit the input port, will eliminate the value of resistor, and since i1 is 0, the voltage source value will become 0. Since this is a voltage dependent source, this can be replaced by short circuit. Hence, I'll get the modified circuit as shown. So for this, if I apply KVL, I'll get V2 is equal to 4i2, which will give me the value directly h22 i2 by v2 to be 1 by 4 mhos. But v1 is the voltage across 2 ohms, and so I can add v1 to be as 2 into i2, which will give me h12 to be v1 by v2, which is 1 by 2. It has no units since it is the ratio of similar quantities. So the next tutorial, I'll leave that as an exercise for you. For this circuit, you have to find the H parameters. That is, in first case, you have to short circuit the output port, and the second case, you have to open circuit the input port. So the answers you can cross check with the answers that I obtained for this tutorial. Moving forward to the 13th tutorial, I asked us to find the ABCD parameters. You know the standard equations of ABCD to be V1 is equal to AV2 minus BI2 and I1 to be CV2 minus DI2. So in first case, when I short circuit the output port, I'll get the modified circuit as shown, which I indicated as circuit A. This again on simplification, that is, as you can see, 4 ohms and 6 ohms will be in parallel, which will give me 2.4 ohms, and this I indicated as circuit B. So now using these two circuits and the condition V2 0, I'll find the values of B as well as D. From circuit A, if I apply current division rule, and get the relation between I1 and I2. So I2 is equal to minus I1 dash, because here the current direction of I1 is in this direction and I2 is in this direction. Both are in opposite direction. That is why I have taken the negative indication. So the current in one of the parallel branches, that is I2, is equal to minus I1, which is the total current, into opposite resistance, which is 6 ohms divided by 6 plus 4. I indicated that as equation 1. So this will give me the value of D, which is minus I1 by I2, to be 5 by 3. Since it is the ratio of similar quantities, it will have no units. From circuit B, if I directly apply KVL, it will give me V1 is equal to 5.4 I1. And if I substitute this in the first equation, it will give me the value of B, which is minus V1 by I2 to be 9 ohms. So the second case, open circuiting the port 2, which will eliminate 4 ohms from the circuit. And here the modified circuit is as shown. You can see that the voltage V2 is the voltage across 6 ohm resistor. So V2 is equal to 6 into I1. And if I apply KVL, V1 will be 9 into I1. So from this, I will get the value of A, which is V1 by V2 to be 9 by 6. And the value of C, which is I1 by V2 to be 1 by 6 ohms. Next, the 14th tutorial has asked us to find ABCD parameters. The first case, as you know, we have to short circuit the output port, and the second case, to open circuit the output port. This, I leave this as an exercise for you, and cross check your answers with the answers that I have obtained for this tutorial. And moving forward to our last tutorial of today's lecture, 15th tutorial, is given the values of all Z as well as Y parameters and asked us to find equivalent T and equivalent pi network. So remember that it is easy to find the equivalent T using Z parameters, and you can find equivalent pi using Y parameters. First, equivalent T network. This is the general representation of equivalent T network. Since we all know the values of all the four values, parameters, just substitute, will give me the equivalent T network as shown. Similarly, if I want the equivalent pi network, this is the general representation of equivalent pi network, and all substitution will give me the equivalent pi network of the given sum. So here are some of the practice sums which I have provided. For Z parameters, as you know, the standard equations are V1 is equal to Z11 I1 plus Z12 I2, and V2 is equal to Z21 I1 plus Z22 I2. For Y parameters, as you know, the standard equations are I1 is equal to Y11 V1 plus Y12 V2, and I2 is equal to Y21 V1 plus Y22 V2. For H parameters, the standard equations are V1 is equal to H11 I1 plus H12 V2, and I2 is equal to H21 I1 plus H22 V2. And lastly, the ABCD parameter standard equations are V1 is equal to AV2 minus BI2, I1 is equal to CV2 minus DI2. This concludes my today's lecture on the tutorials of Z, Y, H and ABCD parameters. In my next and final lecture on two-port network, I will discuss the derivation of interrelation between various parameters. Thank you.